anywhere anymore. The president tweeting out about Maxine Waters, saying this, quote, the president said, Congresswoman Maxine Waters, an extraordinarily low IQ person, has become together with Nancy Pelosi, the face of the Democrat Party. She has just called for harm for supporters, of which there are many, of the Make America Great Again movement. Be careful what you wish for, Max. Okay, what about all of this? Let's bring in our panel. Steve Hayes, editor-in-chief for the Weekly Standard. Mara Liasson, national political correspondent of National Public Radio. And Charles Hurt, opinion editor for the Washington Times. Charlie.
Well, you know, you've probably gone a little too far if you have Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi sort of pulling her chain back a little bit there on her on Maxine Waters' remarks. You know, it's tough. I know that this is the kind of thing that really excites a lot of the sort of most rabid supporters on the left, not necessarily even of the Democratic Party, but on the left, the most vociferous haters of Donald Trump. But it's not helping them win any new voters in the middle. And when you have a debate where you have Donald Trump struggling with the vast complexities on the border, trying to figure out some way to fix this problem that nobody likes, as one choice, and then the other choice is Maxine Waters going out saying, pester these people in public. I think most voters are going to sort of be forced towards the Trump version.
This does happen a lot, it seems, when Democrats are looking at a political upside for a story that maybe is cratering on the Republican side. Then they kind of go over their skis sometimes. Yeah. John Tester and Heidi Heitkamp and Joe Donnelly all have to answer questions about Maxine Waters.
Sure. Look, you just heard Chuck Schumer. He does not want the Democratic Party to be the left-wing mirror image of the things they